So today, we'll use the state and hook to work on the footer. First, let's create a new component. So open your text editor, open components, and here, create a new file, footer.js. We will create a functional component, so add export default function and a component name, appFooter. Then in return, let's just add a div tag with the text footer. Now, let's import this component under app.js. On top, import appFooter. Then at the bottom, after this main tag, add a footer tag. You can also add the ID footer. Then add the appFooter element. Check the preview. You can see footer, it means the component is working. Now, let's add this copyright information using the container component. So open React Bootstrap, click Components, Layout, and Grid. Copy the import of container, then add them under footer.js. You can then remove this div tag and instead add the container element. You can also add the fluid. For the copyright, let's add a div tag with the class copyright. You can copy this copyright text from the website and paste it over here. Once done, check the website, and now we can see this copyright information. Now, let's work on the social media icons. So add another div tag with the class socials. Then add UL, LI, and A tag. The first icon is Facebook. So I want to add facebook.com. For the icon, you can go back to the website. You can then copy the HTML and paste it over here. The second icon is Twitter. So again, copy the HTML and replace it over here. Also, you can update the link from Facebook to Twitter. Then finally, copy this LinkedIn icon, replace it over here, and also update the link to linkedin.com. Change from class to class name. Once done, check the preview. And this time, we can see the social media icons. Now, let's work on this Go to Top button. If you click on them, it should take you to the top of the page and it should be hidden. If you scroll down, it should be visible. If you scroll to the top, it should be hidden. We can do this by using the state. Now, I will show you how to use the state. It should be used at the very top, just after the function. So this is the name of our state. This is used to update the state. And finally, this is the default value of the state. Now let's update the state using use effect lifecycle hook. So add use effect lifecycle hook. Then let's use the scroll event. So here I'll be adding if else statement, and the condition would be if window.scrollY is greater than or equal to 400. I want to update the state value to true. Otherwise, I want to update the state value to false. Now at the bottom, let's use the state and the go to button div. It also has a class called goTop. Check the preview. If you click, nothing happens, but if you go all the way to the top, the button should be hidden. If you scroll down, it should be visible. Now let's add click event on this button so it can go all the way to the top. In this div, add onClick and add a function goTop. Now let's create this function. And inside this function, we will use scrollTo method. We want to set the top value of 0 and behavior to smooth. Once done, take the preview, click on this button, and this time it should be working fine. Great! This is the end of this session. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. Thank you.